Hello, welcome to the Hello, welcome to the Monday, May 11th, 2020 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from with SaltStack. So they had to fix this vulnerability as well. Two actual vulnerabilities. One is the critical authentication bypass vulnerability, and then Android devices have the ability to add their own image types to that library. It's an MMS message, or get you to open it either via web browser, email, or any other methods. And while I believe the author only looked at more recent Samsung devices, this vulnerability apparently now Mina OTP on GitHub is not affected by this. This was something that apparently was then downloaded, modified, and well enriched with additional malicious components. The application gains persistence by adding itself as a launch daemon and launch agent, so it actually tries to run as administrator as well as the local user, and then it is able to load additional modules, but appears the main purpose of this application is an information stealer and sort of one of those remote access tools. Originally, the malicious application was submitted to VirusTotal by a user from Hong Kong in April. Now, back then, it was not at all recognized, but now most antivirus engines on VirusTotal will recognize it as malicious. Well, and that's it for today. Made some changes a little bit to the layout of the front page of the Storm Center today. So if you run to any